Hello and thanks for joining us, folks. The fourth quarter of play should begin momentarily. Now, let's check in with Doris Burke for the Sprite uncontainable game. Doris?
Kev, for the Bulls, it's been an uncontainable game from their reserve small forward. With the way the scoreboard sits right now, you have to wonder if it would be this close without his great play off the bench. He's been a huge factor.
Great, Doris, thanks. And when you look at that textbook contribution, guys, coming from one of the reserves, he really fit that definition here tonight.
Yeah, he's really been the X factor in this game. You know, to be honest, I don't think they were ready for him defensively. It seemed like they just didn't have a plan on how to guard him.
Well, you know, one of the things about having a guy like him come off the bench is that it gives you a burst. He's a power surge, and he creates immediate matchup problems, especially when he gets hot.
On the court for the Bulls, getting this fourth quarter started. Here is Harper. Outside Pippen. It's Jordan on the wing. Working on Anderson.
You know, sometimes the intensity of the game can lead to brain neutral plays like that, guys.
Terrific defensive play to cut him off and square up.
And he took a shot. Excellent toughness to get in there and make a play. I love that kind of work.
Now here is Hardaway. Inside to take the lead. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew Konjac on the shot.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
He hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line.
Miss at the line. Might stick in his craw for a while. Always hurts to miss a chance to take the lead.
Good. 10 points for Jordan.
We just can't let him get that close to the hoop.
Now here is Hardaway. Anderson dishes to O'Neal. Dennis Rodman pulls it in. Rodman's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Dishes it to Pippen. Now the pass to Wennington. Rebound by the Magic. Now Hardaway. Back to Scott. With the lead pass, and Shaq with the slam.
Well, it's been a long battle, but they have finally gotten the game even again.
Yeah, you wonder, though, battling back like that sometimes can give you a mental edge, but other times, maybe you've used too much energy to get all the way back, so we'll see.
And here's Jordan outside, and that one's good. Jordan's got 5 points now this quarter.
He can be dangerous from outside. Sure, he didn't get one to go in the first, but we know he can get on the roll and knock him down.
Now a timeout called by Orlando. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
But he's getting to the rack all game, and if they can't do a better job of keeping him out of the paint, they're in for a long night.
So for the Bulls, Luke Longley's checked in for Wennington. Simpkins comes in for Dennis Rodman. And it's Kukoc in for Scottie Pippen. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Well, over that break, I listened in on what head coach for the Magic was getting across in the huddle. He told the guys that for now, he wants to see them back off the three-point shot, saying all our offense doesn't need to come from perimeter jump shots. Let's get the ball inside for some high-percentage looks.
And Chicago has possession. Magic knocking down the tray.
He got the shot he wanted off that pick, just couldn't get it to fall.
But Steve, they'll take that play all day long, 10 times out of 10. That was good action.
Inside to Shaq.
Ammonia strong finish right there, Parker. You hear me? That was ammonia strong.
Yeah, ripped it down with two hands.
That's about as high percentage as you can get.
And here's Jordan outside. Jordan can't get that one to fall. Orlando leading. Guys, this offense very effective.
Point right at him.
And this is where you just start picking apart the defense, and now you take their confidence away. You can really take control. Not a whole lot they're doing right defensively at this stage after playing a pretty solid first half.
Chicago calls timeout.
Yeah, he's trying to take the wind out of their sails here. I mean, they're on the wrong end of a bad run. I got to sort things out.
I think things were very close to spiraling out of control if he didn't burn one there.
Armstrong's checked in for Orlando. Dennis Rodman, he's checked in for Chicago. Pippen comes in for Ron Harper. We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in. A nice shot by Jordan.
He's starting to feel it. He's going to groove here in the second half.
Now a timeout called by Orlando.
Well, he wants to get everybody on the same wavelength, that's for sure. He may change up some things here as well.
Looks to me like he saw something that wasn't on the plan, and I think now is the time to address it. I don't have a problem with that.
.56 left in the game. Defeat to Hardaway. Double clutches. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
The offense is getting right to the rim, but at least they saved the layup with the foul.
That's old school basketball rules. I mean, at the end of the day, no easy layup. Earn it from the line.
And so both free throws are good. And it's a three-point game.
He's just got such a smooth stroke, and it never changes, even in this kind of high-pressure situation.
And they double up Jordan. Back to Pippen. Jacks up a three. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Jordan.
9 straight points for them off of wide-open looks from deep. Something has to change for this deep.
Yeah, they're just giving up too many easy shots out there. They've got to close out harder, get a hand up, make him put it on the floor.
Now here is Hardaway. Here's Shaq. Yes, and it's Hardaway picking up the assist. Hardaway has got his 4th assist in this one.
They've got the lead despite pretty cold shooting from the field in the first half, and now they're beginning to find their groove.
Well, this is a team capable of getting hot, and if they do, they're going to really extend this lead.
Here's Pippen. Shot clock at 6. Back to Jordan. Pass to Longley. Pippen. For 3! No good. Armstrong with it. He's picked up by Jordan. Armstrong kicks to Shaq. He kicks to Armstrong. The 3 won't fall.
If they know what's good for him, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball into three-point territory.
Well, you're right. Anything less than airtight defense on him will usually result in 3 points.
Chicago calls timeout. They trail by 2. Seconds left in the 4th quarter of this one. What do you think, guys?
You know, looking at how much time they have, I think it's likely we'll see them try to get a good look and score quick.
Yeah, and I think it's a possible 2-for-1 situation, and so the next play they run will be interesting to see what they go with.
Scotty's checked in for Orlando. And a change for the Bulls. Wennington, he's checked in for Luke Longley.
Well, they had a foul to give, but they couldn't get it done before that shot attempt.
Yeah, and giving up free throws isn't ideal here, Steve. You know that, but at least they've got the clock stopped.
It's the first, and that narrows the gap to 1. And so he makes both from the line.
There. 1 mistake and the game's over, but he got it done.
Time called here. The Magic decide to talk it over. 27 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pippen against Hardaway. 15 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Back to Scott. Six to shoot. Right between the eyes. And the crowd roaring to life.
That was a huge shot.
They're just about dancing in the aisles now.
What an eruption in this building.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. They're losing by three. 7 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
Well, down three, you don't necessarily have to go for the three. You could go for the quick bucket and then the foul.
I'm not sure. I mean, in this situation, I think they should look for the three, Steve. I mean, try to tie this thing up. You've got three-point shooters. Let it fly.
Seven seconds left in the fourth quarter. Offensive rebound. Outside Jordan. For the tie. Oh, he couldn't make that shot go to force overtime. And so the big win by Orlando in a tight game. Well, Mark, it was anybody's game right to the very end.
Yeah, it was. The coach is happy with the outcome, but maybe not so much with the margin.
And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, and the whole crew from 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long, and thanks for watching the NBA Eastern Conference Final. Now let's take a look at the Jordan Player of the Game.